a big winner tonight.
He is undefeated in the squared circle.
No one beats us to the punch.
Congrats, Leo. What a spectacular performance. He was down three times. To walk us through the fight.
I knew he was going to be tough. He's got a lot of experience, but I've also got a lot of experience. And I know how tough I am, so I wasn't too worried.
Did you see the openings in there?
Absolutely. Absolutely. He didn't have any his hands up. He didn't have a guard. He had no head movement. He was really flat-footed. I immediately felt like I could unload at any time and catch him, so.
So this was your fourth BKFC fight and your third one in Montana. Is that a special feeling walking out here in front of your home crowd?
I love my hometown. I love Great Falls. I am as tough as I am because of Great Falls. It's a special place. I love it.
Great Falls really seems to be a fight city. There's so many local fighters here on the card. Like, what makes Great Falls and Montana people so tough?
Montana, you gotta be tough to live in Montana. It's a hard place to live. It just looks pretty, but it's a tough place to live.
Now, you're an experienced campaigner already in bare knuckle. What's the secret of preparing for a bare knuckle fight?
Understanding that it's its own sport. It's not boxing without gloves. It's not stand-up MMA. It's not kickboxing. It is bare knuckle fighting. It is a completely different sport, and you have to prepare differently. I tell people all the time, everything hurts. Every punch hurts. You feel it. It doesn't matter. You can take a punch with a boxing glove or MMA glove and not feel it. You feel every punch, regardless of how powerful it may be, in bare knuckle. It's wild.
And I guess you also feel when you actually connect on the opponent, right? It also hurts your hand.
Oh, it feels amazing. I love it. I love putting knuckle to bone, man. It's great.
What was your strategy going into this fight tonight?
To knock him out. That was it. That was my strategy. That was my plan. I didn't have a plan B. I didn't have a plan C. I had every intention on knocking him out.
You're one of the most prominent Native Americans in martial arts. Are you proud to represent your community?
Absolutely. I'm very, very proud of the Native people. I'm very proud to be part of the indigenous culture. Absolutely.
Is that what gives you your fighting spirit?
We're Native Americans are born with a warrior spirit. Absolutely. It's in our lineage.
Talk to us about your nickname, Bushido. Where does that come from?
Bushido is the samurai code of honor. It means the way of the warrior. And I kind of adopted it based on my martial arts background. Has a lot to do with respect, respecting your opponents, respecting the game, honor, loyalty, you know, all those things that I hold close to my heart.
Now, you really showed your power tonight. You're in your 40s now. How many more fights do I have in you?
I know I have another one after this because I'm unhurt. I'm untouched. So, you know, because of my age, I'm aware that father time isn't on my side. However, if I continue to fight like this and I don't get hurt, I have a few left. Absolutely. I really enjoy this.
Is there anyone in particular you want to call out?
No, man, I don't know anybody. I don't have any hate for anybody. Like my opponent tonight, I don't know him. I have no reason to dislike him. I'm going to go have a beer with him after this.
Is there any family sponsors you want to thank?
I've got a lot of local sponsors. I want to thank them all. I can't really think right now, but I just want to say I love you guys. I love Great Falls and I love Montana. My name is Leo Bercier, Great Falls, Montana. I'm with Bare Knuckle News. And no one beats us to the punch.